आई थिंक यू माइट हैव, यू ऑलरेडी हैव डन वर्क ऑन दैट, बट स्टिल अ पार्ट ऑफ सिलेबस. आई जस्ट एक्सप्लेन यू रीडिंग अ फाइल. हैव यू डन वर्क ऑन इट, लाइक हाउ टू रीड अ फाइल इन
यस
पाइथन?
आई हैव
ओके, सो जस्ट लेट्स रिवाइज ऑन दैट. So in Python, there are different ways you can read a file. There are not much resources are available, so this you can refer from this resource, Real Python, where you can get it like how to read a file, and you already aware about it. But still, if anything is missing in, so you can ask me on that. So for reading a file, what you need it, the path from where you want to read a file. Second thing. The delimiter in that file. Delimiter means, do you know delimiter?
No, I don't know what that.
It means that how the values are separated. Whether in CSV file, the delimiter is what? Comma, right? CSV file, you know, comma separated file.
I don't know about that side.
Okay. Okay, so see, there is one file formats are there, comma, separated file. Okay, just like you have seen the file like txt. Txt file is for what? Text file, right? Dot csv is for comma separated file. Similarly, if I say dot JSON, you might have asked me the question key value. JSON file in Java is there. So in that JSON file, the extension is what? Dot JSON. It means the file is a JSON file. Have you done work on docs, document, Word document? What is an extension of
No.
that? Okay, Word document, you haven't done work. Okay, so its extension is docs. Okay, have you installed any software before from your own?
Yes.
So what is an extension of that software file? Any software file?
EXE.
Correct. So it means this is telling you what? It tells you what kind of file they are. Okay. EXE is for executable file. Okay. So now the question is, what is delimiter? Delimiter means in a file, how the values are separated that you represent with the delimiter. So in this comma separated value, CSV data, let me show you the CSV data. If I have, I will show you. Okay, 1 minute, let me check it here. You can see CSV file, right? Now when I click on this file, you can see what you understand from this file. Do you understand anything from here? You can see this, the values are separated by comma. You can see one comma, then after that, this is, so it means that the symbol that you are using to separate a value, they are called as delimiter. Okay. Similarly, sometime in some file, the delimiter use a semicolon to separate the value. Okay. So it means that delimiter means which symbol that you are using to separate the every values of a row. So that was I'm talking about. So when you read a file, this thing you should be take care, like what is the file? In which format the file is, what is the size of file? File name, size of file, type of the file means what is an extension of file that you should be aware. What is the content in that file? Okay, before reading that, you should be aware about it. Now, the next thing is how you are going to read a path. You already aware, right? Like for reading a path, okay, in window, what format we use, forward slash or backward slash to read a file?
Forward slash.
Are you sure?
Yes, I think so.
No. When you click on here, what for? Is it forward slash or backward slash? Backward. See, this.
Yeah, backward.
Right. So when you want to read a file in Windows, you should have a backward slash, because this path you will going to give while reading. So always use this backward slash in this window. However, in Ubuntu's and all, we use this forward slash, means this slash will be converted into this one. So this thing you should remember. However, in the URL, when you read directly file from any URL, at that time it is a forward slash, but from local system, it will be your backward slash. So you can see this, how the path structure we are following, means inside this path, where the file exists, how you can read this with the help of this path. Now let's come to the file, how you can read the file. So now from here onward, there is an open built-in function in Python. Have you used this open function?
Yes.
Okay, so how we do that? File open function, inside this you will give a file name or complete path you will give?
I have not used this. I used context manager, like that context manager I use.
Can you explain me in a detail, like how context manager means?
Yeah, like that is another piece of code. Like here we have to open one file and then we have to close it. There's another way to do it. You can use context manager, like that command is with again open.
Yeah, this one.
As something.
As written. Okay.
Yeah, here we just have to specify the name of the file if it is in the same folder. Otherwise, we'll have to specify the path.
Correct. So here you said absolutely correct. Means when you want to work, when you want to open the file, because this open function will just open a file. So when you want to open the file and print the content, you will going to just write down like this. Let me show you. Have you tried in a command prompt doing the same?
Yeah, I have.
So let me take any file from my download. Okay, this task, okay. Go to this property, copy this path. Inside in the command prompt, we just write Python IDE. Once it Python environment is open, write this file equal to open. Inside that, what is the name of file? Task.txt. Close. Now tell me, will it be run or will it give error?
We have to close the file also.
That's true. But just by looking what we have learned now, based on this syntax,
it will work, but we will not get any output.
Let me show you. I think we will get an error here, but let's check. Okay, it depends on the file. Sometime if you do you know the concept of Unicode character?
No.
If in your file some Unicode character are there, for example URL or some symbol like hyphen or underscore, then in that case it will sometime give an error. Let me check if it is giving error or what. if there is no Unicode present in the file, it will work. Now you see it's giving an error here. Unicode escape codec can't decode byte in a position truncate. Now how you're going to resolve this? Have you ever such error before?
No, I have not got any error like this.
Okay. You need to just add R before this. Now, will it be run? Let's check. See, it's run. Now, if you want to print the file, how you're going to print the file once you're done with this? See this. Whatever the task that are present on my file, it's printed. This was the content of my file. This take home assignment designed to task, designed to test your skill. And let me open the file and show you also. See, same thing. Background, this take home assignment is designed like that. I was talking about the Unicode character, right? If you have a symbol like this hash and this underscore and hyphen like this, if you have, then obviously it will give an error. And that's the reason we got an error. My motive was to tell you this thing because this error is very common. You can try
what
it on
R do.
This R will going to convert this character, whatever we read it, in the form of Unicode. You know Unicode, ASCII code, right? So this R, yeah. When you add an R, it open the file in the Unicode format means, and then we can read it. Unicode means it convert it into the Unicode ASCII value just like that. And then it read the content of file. If you don't use this R, it will directly open the file in a same format. But when you use this R, it will going to read it in a Unicode means whatever symbol you use it, it will able to read that symbol also. Because see, when you try to open the file, opening a file, it doesn't mean that you have just added this instruction and this will open the file. No, it's not like that. Internally, whenever you try to open the file variable will try to read the content of the file first because it has to find it out what is the type of file. Okay. This open function, if you see here, this is written here clearly. If I show you, this is an open built-in function, has a single require argument that is path file to open. And this is opening your file in the form of object, means the content of file they're reading in the form of object. Okay. So this built-in function, they won't be able to read a symbol because this built-in function doesn't having understanding of this symbol. Right, what do you mean by hash, hyphen, underscore? But when you read it in the form of Unicode, they will understand and read each and every character, whether it is single quote, double quote, parenthesis, hyphen. That is the reason when I add it here R, this R will going to read this content in the form of Unicode. And when you print it file.read, it will going to print it on your screen. Is it clear to you right now?
Yeah.
Okay. So now next thing that you said, context manager, right? There is another way where you can read the file with this reader is equal to open dogbreeds.txt. Try. You can write something here, whatever option you want to do it, and you can close the file. Have you tried this exception handling one? This try and finally this one?
I haven't tried and except. I don't know what finally.
Finally, in the sense, see, if you want to execute any instruction in any case, okay, means you want that instruction to be executed anyhow, then that thing we added in a finally. When you add any instruction with this finally, it means you have to, you will get ensure that this code will execute anyhow. So that is the reason. See, there is a try and except block. How this work, try and except block? you write the code here. Okay, here you write the statement. Then you write a statement. In case if there is any error exist, then there is a catch block, respective catch block to handle that. Okay, but in case, suppose if you do not have any error here, then who will going to handle that? Or in case if you do not have any error, okay, or if you have any error that is not handled by this respective catch block, then you need something to print to show to the user that what actually the problem with this code. So in that case, what we do, we add a finally keyword. This finally keyword will going to print anyhow, or it will going to do the operation that you want to do it in all the cases. Let me explain you. See, normally what it happens.
I understood. Like, it means that even if try or catch will not run, finally will run.
Yeah, correct.
And like, it's like if there's no error, means it will run the try part. It will not go to catch because there's no error. It will directly go to finally and close it. And if there is any error, then it will go to catch part. It will skip try. And after that, finally, it will go to the finally part.
Yeah, correct. Very good. Yes.
Okay.
So here, this part, if you don't have any error, obviously, this will not go to this catch block, right? Then you need something, right? What you're going to do in that case, if this not work, there will be the finally part, which will going to do the operation on the behalf of try and catch, and it will going to close it. It will going to close the file. So this, that is the reason we add a finally keyword. So this is another way that you set up context manager and argument one. With open is used when you want to open the file. So do you know why do we use with?
We use with open because like it does not, like we don't have to necessarily close the file.
Yeah, correct. Means when you open the file with with, you don't need to write the reader.close and close the file. They will automatically take care of that. And one more thing, when you write this with open, they will going to check, is this file is really exist on your system? If this file is exist, then it should open it. And if this file is not exist, they will going to like, suppose in case if you want to create a new file, then also you can create it. So with open command is used in case when you want to open the file, and you even if you don't add close the file, it will still work. But in some scenario, if you don't close the file, sometime it error comes if the file size is very large. So the same thing is here written. The with statement automatically take care of closing the file. And once you are done with the operation, whatever statement that you want to do operation, suppose you want to read a file, you want to do operation. Once you are done with it, it's not mandatory to write down reader.close or file.close. So you will prevent your code from getting unexpected error. Now the same thing in the context manager, you can open the file in case of read mode. When you want to only read the file, you can read the file. When you want to update the file, write down something. And what do you mean by this RB and WB open in a binary mode? Do you know this?
No, I don't know this.
Okay. See, internally, you know that system, they understand in the form of binary machine code, right? So when you use this RB and WB mode, they open the file in a binary format. And they write down in the binary format also. So with that, their speed of processing of working get increased because they're directly working on the binary mode. However,
so like, Like if I write some text like my name is Tejas, so when I do write like open an RBOW mode that my name is Tejas, the binary equivalent of that will come.
No, not a binary equivalent of that will come. Means using byte data, yeah, means it will be internally in the binary format they write down so that they can do by fast processing. You want to check it?
Can you give some example for this?
Yeah, let me show you if I have. Okay, let me open with this. Sorry. Okay. Okay. Okay, it's kind of command prompt. Oh, sorry, I forgot to add here single quotes. It's still not able to read. Okay, just 1 minute. Let me do it in.
You're doing it wrong. You said like in command prompt you written with open, but you have to say as something, as some name with open and then as file.
Oh, okay, sorry. Write. Yeah, correct. As reader, sorry. Sorry, I was looking into this, so yeah, sorry. Yes. Okay, let me clear one minute. I'm opening the new one. Yeah, now it's correct. Yes.
Reader dot read write.
Oh, sorry. I think indentation. Sorry, what you said?
You have to write reader dot read write. That's the function dot read. In the print part where you have written.
Okay. Sorry, here I wrote right. Just 1 minute. No, I was just looking why it's giving three dot. Indentation error is coming. Okay, let me write down in the next new file. table 5 6 column, invalid syntax 5 6 column. Okay, let me check it. What was that? It won't be understand from here. Okay, let me open it in a notepad plus. Five, six. Okay, symbol. I think it won't be able to read. Okay, again, table 5 6 column. What? But it is giving 5 6 column by it is giving file.py 5 6 invalid syntax on table 5 6. Is there any table 5 6 here? No, right? Then why table it is showing? Okay, just 1 minute, okay? Let me check it. Can you parallelly try on your system with any other file? Or let me check if I have
another. Yeah, I'll try.
Receiver dot here. Okay, let me try with other file. Is still giving the same error, table 5 6 column. Let me check if there is any example in the code. Because I have one more. Okay, 1 minute, let me check. Did you try it?
I'm trying.
So because I think might be a file. Okay, no such file directory. Okay, yaar. Might be the file error, but let me ensure it. Without ensuring, I can't say file error. Input buffer reader. Okay, I'm reading this. Yeah, see here. I am able to do it. Tejas,
Yes.
you can see here. This is my one file receiver. Okay, let me open this file first. Where is here? Yes. So here I have a JSON code. This you can see the JSON code I have. And here, what I'm doing here, I am just opening this file in the read mode. RB mode, you can see here. This line. Might be it is not working with this that context, like with open, but here when I'm opening this file in this read mode and I print this type file, it is showing this buffer reader. Buffer reader means in a binary format, you are reading this file. And when I'm printing it, it's printing the same content, but it is reading in a binary format. So that it can easy to read it means normally when we convert a file so that system they can understand and system they can understand it. So that's why we read it in a write mode or read mode. Just check once on your system.
Yes, I'm checking it only.
Yeah, okay. Can you share your screen?
Just a second, yeah, I'm sharing.
Okay. I have just allow you to share it. I'm stop shared.
Yes, it is working for me also, but it worked with a context manager as well. I think you must have done something wrong.
Can you
So
show?
I have written just like this. I'll write something else also. I'll just write anything.
Okay.
So I'll save this, and then in Notepad I wrote this code. So I wrote this as reader, and I am printing the reader, and then in command prompt, see.
But it is not showing you the content of file, right? It is showing,
Okay.
it is just printing the path. Yeah, now you type it, yes. Save it. I think you haven't saved. Save,
Saved.
yeah, okay. So see, it is giving you B at first. Do you have a B on before that? No, content of the file, yeah. You don't have, right? Why? Because that B is showing that you are reading the binary data. Internally, it is reading in a binary format. Might be because I am having in my file too many space and symbol, that's why it's not reading. Let me try it with a simple file. Just remove R, remove the R. Yes, not right. Because in my code, R is not there. See, it's giving error, right?
Yeah, but that you are done. You are in spite of that, you are getting error.
Yeah, that is I'm getting, but I just checking there. No, because the thing is that in my file, the content is more and lot of symbols are there. That's the reason I might be not able to read it. Okay, we can do one thing.
Let's do one thing. You can just whatever is there in your file, just send it on Zoom chat.
Okay, yeah.
I can try it.
Okay, yes. Otherwise, I can attach on this Zoom Meet only. There's
You
an
can
option.
also send. Yeah, you
Yeah.
can ask remote control. I'll give it.
Yeah, there is an option of attaching.
I've given you remote control. Now
Okay.
you can directly paste this here.
Okay, yeah, 1 minute. No, it's not coming. I'm trying to print it. I just paste it, but it is pasting, I think, your path. See here.
Okay.
1 minute. Let me.
It's then you just share it on Zoom chat.
I'll send it on a chat. Just paste it in your file.
Yeah. Save the file
Yes.
and I've saved it. Run it again. Yeah, it's working.
But in my, when I'm trying to read it, why it's giving error? But I did the same thing, right? With
Yeah, you did the same thing.
maybe I think indentation error or something error because of that
Yeah,
it.
something like that, right?
Okay, yeah, no issue. Okay, can you? Okay, just 1 minute. Let me check if there is an option to attach another file. Okay, but it's work for one, but obviously it will work for other also. So this way you
Yeah.
can read this binary data. That B that is coming with the data, it means that convert the data in the binary format. And you are reading it actual data, but it is allowing you to read in the binary formats. So
Yeah,
that
but means it is means it I can read it the same way it was before, but it will but it is has been converted to binary format and it will be faster processing.
yeah, correct. So this binary,
Understood. Yeah.
when we work directly on the binary data, obviously the performance of the system increases. Because you are working on that language that system can directly understand. So it's similar to like instead of going to the translator, you are directly working on, you're directly dealing with the system. So that's the reason this open in a binary mode. Here you can see read and write using byte data. So you are reading in a byte data, converting into the binary format and reading byte data. And other syntax are same. Like if you want to append it or if you want to add it, you can simply, if you want to write down the file, open in a WB mode, change the file and add it, right? So this way you can simply add the content. So you already know this one, reader.read, that we were doing it. I was typing open. Sorry, I forgot about the function name here. But actually, this is a read one. We need to just use read. And this thing is optional. Miss, not optional. Miss, you can use any name here. The rest are also. And do you know the difference between read line and read?
Yeah, read line with you will get all the lines separately, and in read you will get everything in one line only.
Yes, correct. So this read line function, you can get the data, and
what is that 5 as parameter? That I don't know.
This is 5 byte of line means 5 data of that particular line.
Okay, so here, okay, like only 5 things of
yes,
that line.
Yes, correct. Right. So you can see here the space with space also, right? It counted the space also. So whatever you pass it here, this is the byte of the data. Means how many byte of data you want to read it here. So here this 5 byte of data that you are reading, if you change it to this, it will count the space also.
Okay, got it.
Similarly, there are a lot of options are there for reading the file, but this is already, you know, so we can't, means we won't go in much deep, but you can practice this on how to write it. Okay, I have not told you this one, right? You also know this one, right? If you want to open this file and you want to write down this file, just use this dot write function and add this content.
Yeah.
So this will go into edit. Yeah. So that's it in this one, reading and writing the file. Rest, we have a exception handling that I think I will start tomorrow only. Exception handling is a big module, but this file I will share with you. You know, this thing you already know, but just run once again, like how to read the content. It won't work in the notebook, okay? Because this is your local system path and of the drive. You know how to access the drive content with the help of this notebook collab?
No, I don't use it much. If I will want to try, I will use it with VS Code.
Okay, so this, will you able to do it in a VS Code? This one, it is same
yeah,
thing.
I am very comfortable with VS Code.
Okay, so here this is same thing what I have explained you, this file reading and all, it's same thing. It's how to close the file content with proper example I have added here. Just read in that format. So tomorrow 7 to 8, I'm scheduling the class. Okay. 7 to 8. So we can do a lot of things tomorrow. I'm planning to complete your this exception handling. And we are left with few more modules.
So after this, what will come? Python advanced programming.
That I think for you, data science. Have you data science will come? I think so. I am not sure, but
okay.
This will get complete. This command line argument are same thing. Is not much take times. String pattern matching, date time. It won't take time. It will complete in 1 days. Tomorrow I will complete this one part, error exception. This one is done today. And let's see this tomorrow, day after tomorrow. So this, I will complete this one and we'll start data science.
Yeah, okay.
If it is, you are opt for data science, you opt for which courses?
When I adopted Hackweather, they told after this, you will get either web development with Django or data science.
Okay. So which you want to proceed? Django or data science?
I prefer data science only.
Then okay, we will start data science and I will convert into data science to you.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, then you practice this and tell me your mail ID. Can you sh okay, I was going to share with you.
Yeah, I
Basically,
also wanted to learn competitive coding, so like, is there no course for that?
yeah, I will speak with sir and we have a course. I will definitely teach you.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah.